You all have seen the film, and I'm going to add to your understanding of the film. The modern film industry got its start in the late 19th century, thanks to the invention of this man, who is known as the Wizard of Menlo Park, also Thomas Alva Edison. Edison invented a motion picture camera, and he opened the very first movie theater in 1896. In 1913, Thomas Edison invented the first talking movies. And with the introduction of color films in the 1930s, Hollywood began influencing the thoughts and the behavior of millions of people around the globe. Advances in film technology, such as Technicolor and Dolby Sound and 3D and computer-generated imagery, continued to change throughout the 20th century. And the first major breakthrough in film in the 21st century occurred on December the 18th, 2009, when James Cameron released Avatar, and movie making will never be the same. I want you all to be conscious of where we are at this particular point in time. In just 7 weeks since its release, Avatar has become the highest grossing film in film industry. This weekend, its gross receipts will exceed $1.8 billion in 7 weeks. Some critics have praised Avatar as a groundbreaking film with dazzling 3D effects and breathtaking landscapes of this alien world, Pandora, where the story unfolds. The film has also received a great deal of criticism from a broad cross-section of society. There are those in this country who claim that the film Avatar is racist. There are others who say that the film perpetuates the white savior syndrome. There are some who say that the film is anti-military. Others who say the film is pro-smoking. There are others who say the film is anti-big business and that it advocates a radical environmental propaganda. And there are some who say that the film promotes pseudo-spiritual worship of nature. Now, we're going to talk about all of these issues tonight. Avatar does what any good film is supposed to do, and that is to stir up controversy. Because controversy puts meat in the seats, and it translates into increased ticket sales. James Cameron's Avatar is agitation propaganda at its best. Agiprop, as it's also known. The term agitation propaganda originated in Russia during the Bolshevik Revolution around the 1920s. And the term simply meant the dissemination of ideas. It was not a negative term. And it was used by political leftists throughout Europe and the Americas in the 1920s and 1930s. Specifically, agitation propaganda was supposed to affect your consciousness in two ways. Propaganda acts on the mind, and agitation was designed to act on your emotions. So I want us to begin to understand how people work to affect your psyche, oftentimes without us even being aware of it. It's a powerful tool. Agitation propaganda has been used in Hollywood to win the hearts and the minds of audiences for decades. And one of the earliest pieces of agitation propaganda was a film I'm sure you all heard of, The Birth of a Nation, 1915. Other examples of agitation propaganda could be good or bad depending on your perspective. Another example of agitation propaganda is Gone with the Wind, 1939. The film Network, 1976. We're mad as hell, and what? We're not going to take it anymore. All right? Another wonderful film about agitation propaganda was the film Platoon, which came out in 1986. Another great piece of agitation propaganda, which I hope you all have seen, is a film called Sankofa, written, produced, and directed by our very own Holly Garima. And another great piece of agitation propaganda is Michael Clayton, which came out in 2007. Documentaries also advocate certain ideological views, which usually appeal to smaller audiences. But every once in a while, a documentary will cross over into the mainstream. Recent examples include Bowling for Columbine, An Inconvenient Truth by Al Gore, and Fahrenheit 9/11. Michael Moore is probably one of the most popular people in the industry who promotes these pieces of agitation propaganda. Agiprop has been frequently used in science fiction films to make indirect political statements, such as in the film The Day the Earth Stood Still, which came out in 1951. It was a film about the arms race. It was anti-military film, using science fiction as a medium to convey a message. Another powerful piece of agitation propaganda in the science fiction realm was the film The War of the Worlds, which came out in 1953. That film was anti-imperialism, not just science fiction. These movies aren't just movies. They have an agenda. And another profound piece of science fiction agitprop was the film Godzilla, which came out in 1956. Godzilla was about the anti-nuclear warfare issue. Because remember, Japan was the only nation which received nuclear weapons. Bombs were dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. So the Japanese were unable to have an army as a result of them surrendering, and they could not really express their displeasure of what happened to them as a people. So they produced this film, Godzilla, which if you've seen the film, it was about this lizard that was genetically mutated as a result of an atomic explosion, and it destroyed their city. So Godzilla was the United States destroying Japan. Agitation propaganda. Hollywood has been a consistent source of agiprop, and it has been used in every major studio. Hollywood is the world leader in the show business industry. And anybody in show business would tell you that the industry is 5% show and 95% business. It is a dog-eat-dog world, and you're only as big as your last hit. And right now, James Cameron is the biggest name in Hollywood. He is the biggest name in show business. His last film, which was released in 1997, Titanic, that film grossed $1.85 billion since its release. And that's just ticket sales, doesn't count DVDs. And Avatar will sink the Titanic this weekend, probably by Saturday. It will exceed $1.85 billion. Avatar is the most significant piece of agitation propaganda in the 21st century. Avatar is distributed by 20th Century Fox. 20th Century Fox, as in Fox News, a major source of right-wing agitation propaganda. And this is not a conflict of interest for them, because the business of business is business. And as George M. Cohan said, there's no business like show business, all right? So another reality is that the movie industry has always been dominated by white males who greenlight films that perpetuate their racial and sexual view of the world. And because of the fact that there's very little originality in Hollywood, most films that are produced today